Today's evening devotional. Peter speaks up. He saith unto them, But whom say ye that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Matthew chapter 16 verses 15 and 16. From the first, Peter had believed Jesus to be the Messiah. Many others who had been convicted by the preaching of John the Baptist, and had accepted Christ, began to doubt as to John's mission when he was imprisoned and put to death, and they now doubted that Jesus was the Messiah, for whom they had looked so long. But Peter and his companions turned not from their allegiance. The vacillating course of those who praised yesterday and condemned today did not destroy the faith of the true follower of the Savior. Peter had expressed the faith of the 12. Yet the disciples were still far from understanding Christ's mission. The opposition and misrepresentation of the priests and rulers, while it could not turn them away from Christ, still caused them great perplexity. From time to time precious rays of light from Jesus shone upon them, yet often they were like men groping among shadows. But on this day, before they were brought face to face with the great trial of their faith, the Holy Spirit rested upon them in power. For a little time their eyes were turned away from the things which are seen, to behold the things which are not seen, 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 18. Beneath the guise of humanity they discerned the glory of the Son of God. The truth which Peter had confessed is the foundation of the believer's faith. It is that which Christ himself has declared to be eternal life. But the possession of this knowledge was no ground for self-glorification. Through no wisdom or goodness of his own had it been revealed to Peter. Never can humanity, of itself, attain to a knowledge of the divine. It is as high as heaven, what canst thou do? Deeper than hell, what canst thou know? Job chapter 11 verse 8. Only the spirit of adoption can reveal to us the deep things of God, which eye hath not seen, not ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man. God hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit, for the Spirit searcheth all things, yet the deep things of God, 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verses 9 and 10.